Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of WebInformant.tv. I'm David Strom, your host and reviewer. Today, we look at Symantec's Protection Network and its online backup service. It's for a variety of Windows PCs and makes offsite backups easier, making copies of your files that are stored on their servers over the Internet. Why bother with this? Several reasons. If you've ever had your laptop stolen, like I have, you'll need this to fall back on. Second, the best backups are ones that you don't have to remember to do, and this is pretty much set and forget. Finally, it isn't very costly and only requires a reasonably fast internet connection to work. We're looking at the home login page of SPN, and you'll see there are three different services offered: straight online backup, a separate version that works for Windows server-based Backup Exec software. You can sign up for both for a month of free service that will entitle you to 10 gigs of storage for each. Once the trial is done, this will cost you $10 apiece per month for the basic service, and there's also a beta service for online remote access. Once you register and log in, you start out by clicking on Add a Computer and registering a new machine, downloading the installer agent, and then running it on the desktop you want to protect. The service will send you a confirmation email to verify your intentions. Once that's done, you go into My Services screen, click on the backup link here next to the computer that you want to start backing up. You're then browsing your file system and can select the collection of files for your first backup. To make sure things are working, I suggest just picking a couple of small files to see if they get copied to the service. We click on the plus signs to expand the directory tree and click on the files or directories we're interested in. That's really all there is to it. You can also set up schedules to start backups in off hours so they don't tie up your internet connection or when you're actively using your PC by clicking here on the Set Schedule link on the left. If you do this, you should also set your PC power options so your system doesn't go to sleep at night and it can continue to do the backups, as shown here in this control panel. You can monitor what's been backed up and what's in progress on this screen by going to the link on the computer profile, and you can see what jobs have been completed and other details. You can also monitor what's going on from your desktop by bringing up this screen from your taskbar and shows more status information. What about the more important process, restoring deleted files? We go to the online backup services and click on the restore link on the right, and we'll walk you through the process of what files and where to put them on your computer. You can either search for a particular file by name or use the browser to walk through your file system. What are some of the things I liked? Symantec offers a premium service where they will store your file history for up to 7 years. There aren't too many companies that can make good on that kind of guarantee. This means if you delete something, you can go back in time to find a copy to recover it. Speaking of recovering things, Symantec also has an arrangement with NCC Group where they will store your passphrase independently of your backups, should you need to recover that. The service is free of charge as long as you have an SPN account. Also, you should know that Symantec has big plans for its SPN service and will be adding other services over time. Given its humongous product portfolio, this is clearly a place to watch. What are some of the things I didn't like? For one thing, you don't want to run this on a slow internet connection. I was using a cable modem with 300 kilobit uploads, and it still took about 2 minutes per megabyte of data that I was backing up. The more files you have, the longer it'll take. And files that are gigabytes or more in size will take hours or even days. You might want to test your internet connection on this site using different times of day if you don't know what your upload speed is. I also didn't like the lack of visible progress indicators when backing up large files, and Symantec promises to make improvements in this area. And it'd be nice if the screen showing progress will report in your local time zone rather than GMT. Finally, the product can't back up files across network shares. They have to be on locally attached storages. So if you don't yet use any online backup service, take a look at what Symantec offers. Thanks for watching, and check out our other screencast reviews at webinformant.tv. This is David Strom. Feel free to send me comments to david@strom.com.